Don't say mon ami in French. It is a big cliché. French people would never use it to translate something such as hello my friend. Never ever. But you might be thinking, why Geraldine? I've heard that everywhere in movies with French characters. Like in Beauty and the Beast with Lumière. Well, listen.
Well, Lumière, old friend. Shall we let bygones be bygones?
Of course, mon ami. I told you she would break the spell.
I beg your pardon, old friend.
Are you saying that Disney lied to me? Well, yes, I kind of am, because if you use mon ami alone, as in a translation of hello, my friend, for example, it's a complete cliché and you will look like a tourist who only knows those. So today I'm going to help you fix that and show you what to do instead. Bonjour, I'm Géraldine, your French teacher. Welcome to Comme une Française. Today, like every Tuesday, I'm here to help you get better at speaking and understanding everyday French. Mon ami means my friend. However, in every American movie that has a French character, they kind of have to say it at some point, as we saw in La Belle et la Bête. It's kind of when the characters say bonjour with a super heavy accent, bonjour. It shows that they are French, okay, we get that, but no one ever would say anything like that in France. And by the way, in the French version of La Belle et la Bête, do you know what nationality Lumière is?
Il y a le pour et il y a le contre.
He kind of sounds Italian, or at least this is what his accent implies. Of course, if you took your children to see the original version in 1991 in a non-French country, you didn't notice any of this. But now you can, because he rolls his R's in a very non-French way.
Il y a le pour et il y a le contre.
He says rrr. Il y a le pour et le contre. I'm overdoing this on purpose, but this is not a French R. This is rrr. The French R is rrr, very much at the back of the mouth. So absolutely not that. However, in movies, switching from Italian to French is very common.
Oh, elle est si touchante, elle sent qu'elle ne pourra pas résister longtemps. Mia amore, ragazza, avec Pepe tout se passera bien.
Using mon ami alone as, for example, hello my friend, will only make you sound like this kind of cliché, which is not what you want. It's kind of the oral version of looking like that to sound French. Or like that, and that's Super Dupont, a superhero which is a stereotype by French people, of French people, by Marcel Gottlieb. And you deserve better in your French. Mon ami is used for close friends. And obviously you can use that in a proper sentence. If you want to introduce a friend, for example. Je te présente mon ami Marie. Je te présente mon ami Marie. Let me introduce you to my friend Mary. But on its own, for example, bonjour mon ami, comment ça va? That's such a big cliché. And it's just a mistake, it's okay, it's no big deal. For example, when I was working in Leeds in England, people every 14th of July would wish me Happy Bastille Day in French, which was very kind and very nice. But if you want to learn French, it would be interesting to know that le jour de la Bastille or la fête de la Bastille doesn't exist at all. We say le 14 juillet, that's it. Instead of using mon ami, you can simply use your friend's name if you want. For example, instead of saying je suis là mon ami, you can say je suis là Marc, if your friend is called Marc. Or you can just remove it. For example, instead of using the cliché bonjour mon ami, just say bonjour, and that's really good. The scary thing is that it's a mistake that you made in good faith because you wanted to sound French. And the scary thing is that it's not the only one. For example, you might say bien fait to say well done when it actually means serves you right, so don't do that. Or you're saying bonjour twice to the same person during the day when it's actually kind of offensive. Yeah, it's scary. So to prevent you from making more of those mistakes, I made a playlist here with all the lessons that I made about those embarrassing mistakes. Bien fait, why you should not say bonjour twice, and more embarrassing mistakes that you have to check out. Don't be afraid, we can share stories in the comments afterwards, but first, click on the link here and watch those lessons. I will see you in the next video. Salut!